friends, this is Strawberry Jelly, and today I am bringing to you another video showing you how you can build every character for every possible role in Genshin Impact. This is a video that I'm very excited about, and I hope it's going to be helpful to you. For me, I have a hard time building characters as I do not possess the big brain, math knowledge, and looking for guides on YouTube feels very time consuming. Especially because character-specific guides don't always explain the alternatives, for example, why did they use a particular artifact set or weapon, and what would be the specific damage difference if they had gone for other options. So with this guide, you will be able to take the power into your own hands and figure things out for yourself. But first, I just really want to thank you for 1k subscribers. I'm very thankful for everyone that has hit that subscribe button and has given me a chance, and I hope that from now on I can continue to grow and bring you guys great content. If you're new to the Jelly Gang, I hope that you ate all of your breakfast. Please consider subscribing for more content like this, and if you're already subscribed, kindly jingle all my bells to get notifications when I upload a new video. Let's get started. We're going to use the Genshin Impact Calculator. I'm not affiliated with this website, I just think it's very useful and I wanted to share this with you. When you first open this website, I'm sure there are two things that come in your mind. The first one probably is, thank God it's not another spreadsheet, and the second one is, gosh, this looks complicated. But please don't worry, I'm here to show you that this is a very easy tool to use and it will drastically change the ways you look at your characters and improve your damage by a lot. Let's take this from the top. I'm going to explain this from left to right. In order to build a character, we must first select one from this plus button. For this demonstration, I am going to choose Chi-Chi. By pressing the plus button, all the characters that are currently in the game show up. You only need to select the character you desire. An important prerequisite is that the character needs to have been released in-game. But fear not, new characters are added to this list on the day of their in-game release. This is a level 1 Chi-Chi, equipped with a level 1 sword that she comes with. We know that by looking in the middle column, at the character tab, specifically the part that says level 1. On the same tab, you can see that there is an option to add constellations, attack level, skill level, and burst level. These are all by default at level 1. You're meant to fill in that information corresponding to your character's current in-game values. Below the character tab is the weapon tab. Currently, the default weapon is the cool steel. Next to it, you can see the level of the weapon. You can also add the level of refinement of your weapon. Click on cool steel and a list comes up showing all the available swords that are currently in the game. Of course, the list changes in order to reflect the correct weapon type for each character that you have selected. Choose the one you have, but if you're wondering what would be the best weapon for Chi-Chi, or respectively for your chosen character, then click on the optimize option weapon. If you scroll down, you will see the output, meaning a list with all the swords starting from best to worst for your selected character. Note that this list reflects the best damage output for the target default. I will be covering this in more detail at a later part of this video, but for now, just know that default means DPS. Of course, there are other roles available for your character. You only need to click on the target list and choose what is best for you. The program will automatically select the best weapon for the character. Usually, that would be a 5-star weapon, and so potentially hard to get. So for me, I will look at the substats, for example, if it has energy recharge, crit rate, or attack percent, and see if there is a 4-star or maybe 3-star weapon that has similar substats. Alternatively, if you have more than one weapon and you don't know which one is the best for your character, you can try different builds by selecting one weapon at a time and see how that affects her damage output. Knowing all this, let's fill in the gaps and see how the numbers on the right and left column change. The left column shows the attributes of your selected character, for example, the base stats, advanced stats, buffs, elemental type, etc. While the right column shows their damage output. For my case, I am using Chi-Chi as my DPS. I have leveled up all of her skills. I'm using the black sword at refinement 2. As you can see, both the attributes on the left and the damage on the right have changed, as they have both increased. Let's take a closer look at the damage output on the right side. The numbers that you're currently seeing are very big, and that is because this calculator calculates the raw damage your character is capable of. But as you may know, in Genshin Impact, there are damage modifiers based on who you are fighting, the level of your characters, etc. Here are some examples for you to understand this better. If your character is lower level compared to who you're fighting, they will do less damage compared to the amount they would do if they were the same level. Similarly, each enemy has its own specialized resistances. I will put a graphic here on the screen and in the description so you can save it if you want and have a look later. As such, in order to fix our character damage to be realistic, we need to turn on enemy modifiers. There are three options you can choose from: what element is the enemy affected by, the enemy level, and the enemy resistances. Please note that if you want to experiment with the Thunder Shooter or Lava Walker artifact sets, I will show you how to do this in a little part of this video, you need to select Electro or Pyro respectively in this part, as the prerequisite for these sets to work is that the enemy needs to be affected by the desired element already. For this example, I will adjust the enemy level at 70 and check the use of the enemy calculator option. Don't worry if the damage still looks awfully low, as we haven't added the artifacts yet. But before we move on, I would like to take a moment to explain the damage column to make sure that you guys understand it well. So the damage column has four distinct categories: hit type, non-crit, crit, and average. Hit type is basically the type of attack that you're using, for example, DPS is your normal attack. Then the average number is usually between the non-crit and crit values. It shows you a good estimation of your overall damage. Then we have a more detailed breakdown of the normal attacks. We see how much damage each hit will do, then charge attacks, plunge, low plunge, high plunge, all that stuff. Then we see the available elemental reactions the element of our character can create. In this case, superconduct and melt. Next, we see a breakdown of our elemental skill, in this case, Herald of Frost. Notice that if a damage number has a special color, then it is elemental damage, in this case blue, so cryo damage. Then we have the elemental burst information, the skill damage, energy cost, etc. Then we have passives, in this case she doesn't have any relevant passives. Then we have constellations, again in my case I don't have any. Finally, we see the artifact set effects. That is where the details of your selected artifacts will show up. Let's click over to the artifact tab and take a look at the information. The first thing you need to do is go to target, click on default, and select the role you want your character to play on your team. The list presents the options that you have. Default is DPS, so if you want your character to be DPS, don't change it. Then you have the option to focus either on your elemental skill or your elemental burst and more. Notice that if, for example, I click Herald of Frost Damage, on the right side column, the program puts a green square around my elemental skill damage. That is done in order to visually help you focus on the role you choose. Similarly, if I choose Burst Damage, then my elemental skill will be highlighted. Alternatively, if you want to use your character to focus on elemental reactions, then choose something like Vaporize or Melt. For its character, there are a lot of options, so make sure you read, understand them, and choose the one that is best for you. For the sake of this example, I'm going to leave target at default, as Chi-Chi is my DPS. After we're done selecting the character role, we're going to click on Optimize Set Effects. This option will automatically select the best artifact combination for this role. Don't pay much attention to the substats or main stats, as for now, we're just selecting the optimal artifact set combination. If you scroll down in the middle column, you will see more artifact combinations and their respective damage output. The one that is placed price higher is the one that is currently being displayed and is the best option according to the program. What I really like is that you can choose to see what is the next best solution combination and choose what is best for you. Now, in order to fix the main stats of the artifacts, we need to go over to Artifact and select each artifact type and then click on Optimize Main Stat. As you can see, compared to before, some things have changed. And now, for example, my goblet's main stat is physical damage. On this step, make sure that all of the artifacts are maxed out at plus 20. Now, we're presented with a bit of an interesting number situation. And that is because, at the moment, the program is taking only into consideration the main stats of our artifacts. As you can see, there are absolutely no substats. There has been a lot of discussion about how you need to try and get perfect artifacts and how this can improve your damage, but I quite like this step because you can see that at least even if you have horrible luck and you roll awful substats like defense and HP everywhere, this is the minimum amount of damage that you will be doing. For the next step, we are going to optimize the substats over artifacts. In order to do that, we need to go again to Artifact, select each type of artifact and click on Optimize Substats. The program will determine which are the optimal substats for each artifact. If you want, you can compare the amount of damage to the flat damage you were doing without substats and see how much it has increased. At the bottom of the middle column, we now see different substat combinations and how much this could increase your damage. At this point, I would like to say that this is just a calculator and it gives you solutions on how to solve your problem, which is how you want to build your character. It is up to you to look at these numbers and see if they're relevant to you or if you want to try to mix and match to find a different build that is more suitable for your playstyle. Now, you might have noticed the option Optimize from Storage. Basically, this means that you can input the information of the artifacts you already have in the game, and then this program will choose only from that pool to show you which are the most suitable for your character. Moving on to party paths. First, you can choose the Elemental Resonance. This is pretty straightforward. It is even color-coded, so I don't think you have any problem with that. Then you can choose Elemental Reaction Superconduct, which basically decreases the physical resistance by 40%. Then you can choose to apply party member abilities, for example, the very famous Bennett's Inspiration Field. Then artifact paths, where you see the effect of an artifact set equipped by your teammates. For example, the Viridescent, which decreases the elemental resistance to the element which it swirls with for 40%. Then we have weapon buffs, for example, the very famous Legacy Book that increases the attack of the character that takes the field. And then finally, there is the last option for food buffs and other buffs. This part feels very specific and specialized, but if you're a person that likes to push things to the fullest, this is the place for you. Moving on to the advanced tab, we see that there is something called the reaction mode. I personally haven't used this tab yet, but from what I understand, it calculates the elemental reaction damage that can be procced during battle. I might be wrong though. Of course, everything is explained as you can see in the text on this column. If you want to use it, great. I feel it's a bit very specific and for someone that is building a physical DPS, not very useful. Finally, we have the help section, where if something is not working as you think it should, go here and have a read. What is important to mention is that you need to save your builds. If not, when you refresh this page, it will disappear. In order to save your builds, you need to make an account on this website and log in. As we see in the FAQ, how do I save? You basically need to right-click on the portrait of the slot you want to save, click Save As, and it will also give you the option to rename your save. Next time you visit the website, simply choose the character you want, then right-click and load build. Again, this program is only here to do the math for you. The output is there so that the user can make sense of the result and choose what is best for their team. In order to illustrate this, I'm going to give you an example with Sucrose. Say I want to have Sucrose as my main DPS, and I left the target at default. Then Optimize Set Effects gives me for the first option Retracing Volatile 4P set. Now this is a bit stupid, but because, I mean, it can work, but it means that she needs to constantly have a shield around her. Especially in co-op, this can be very situational. The second suggestion is the Heart of the Depths, which gives you a Hydro bonus. So, you know, Sucrose can't really use Hydro bonus or benefit from that. So maybe for my playstyle, I would choose option 3, aka 2-piece Gladiator's Finale and 2-piece Viridescent Veneer. So again, read the output and decide for yourself. I hope this example was useful to you and that overall you learned something new today. This tool is very simple to use and I'm grateful to the person that made it. So now, go out in the world, make your own builds, try things out, and don't depend on other people to tell you what is good or not. Make that decision for yourself. Take control. So that was all for the day. Thank you for watching. If you find this video helpful, please consider subscribing and let me know in the comments below if you're actually going to give this a try. I am Strawberry Jelly and I will see you next time. Bye!